So hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to solve the error range error index invalid value not in inclusive range something according to your range in Flutter. So I'm going to show you why this error occurs and how to solve this error. So it's universal solution for this, and only the range of the range or count varies accordingly. So there is a universal solution for it. Okay, so now let me show you why this error occurs. So before going to that, let me show my code. Okay, and I have just a basic code. So this is a function that returns buttons. Okay, so it's just basically a quiz app. Okay, as you can see here, I'm passing the dictionary or map, you can call it anyway. I'm passing it to the button function and it returns in the form of options. So I will get four options. So as you can see here, I am passing it, and these are that map or dictionary that I told you. So this is for one question, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So totally I have only 5 questions over here. So now I will run and show this code to you. So if I just run it, so I am not using the emulator, I am using just projecting my phone screen into it. So this is that app. So now if I just click one, what is once I will give something to something, whatever, I will do wrong options. So now we are in the second, third question. So 3 and 4, and now we are in the last question. Now if I click a button, so this basically how it works is that if I click a button, the question value gets incremented by 1. So if the question count is 1, it goes to the next question. It's like an index. I have placed an index array of questions. So from 0 index till the 4th index. So it is going to be from 0 to 4. That is basically 5 questions. So if the count is 4 and it correspondingly refers to the 4 indexes of my questions. And if the count goes to 5, there isn't any 5th index basically. So if I just press any value, you are getting that error. So it's basically when you run out of values, this error occurs. So that's the thing. And to solve this error, you can basically give, you can keep a counter, and if the counter reaches that limit value, you can just stop the process or terminate the process, or you can even return a pop-up message saying that you have reached the end. So now in my case, you say I have a count. Okay, I have kept a count over here. So whenever the button is pressed, the counter value will be getting incremented. So when the counter value reaches 5, I need to stop this process because I told you I have only 5 questions. So best way to do is by using a ternary operator. So this solution is exclusive for my quiz app, so my problem. So it can vary for you depending on whatever app you're doing. So this is not a generic one. So for me, I will go over here. Okay, so here I'm going to place the condition, ternary condition. So if count, okay, so count gets incremented every time when the button is pressed. Okay, so count less than 5. Okay, I will put this ternary operator. So ternary operator, you know, question mark and that colon thing. So I will put a question mark over here. Okay, so this is the condition. Okay, if the condition is true, okay, if the count value is less than 5, this column will get executed. So this column has the function. Okay, so this column has that function, and this function goes on to the calls the set of options, and we get to see the questions and its corresponding options. Okay, so if the count is less than it, we will be getting the subsequent questions and its options. But what if the count equals or becomes greater than 5? We will put that in the, it's like basically if else condition. So if condition is this one, and the statement, if condition statement, is column, and the else condition is going to be that colon thing. Okay, so I will place the colon outside the, what to say, where is that, outside the column. So it's as I have placed the condition, where is it, as I have placed the condition before the column, so it's going to be inside the safe area and inside the center. So you have to be careful here also. So here it is, that column, here it ends. So you need to place the else condition. So else is this colon. Else condition, I will display a raised button. Okay, I will display a raised button, and it will have an text. Okay, text is enough, I think. So child and text saying that you have ran out of questions. Okay, so that's it. So now if the count, if I go above the fifth question, this column won't get executed. So therefore, I won't get, the function won't be called and I won't get any question and its options. Rather, this raised button will be displayed. So now if I run this code, so now if I will show you, so if I just click something, so as you can see, I am getting the option, you have ran out of questions, okay? I've pressed it same 5 times and I have ran out of questions. And here I'm not getting the error. So if you are doing, in my case, some apps like this, you can place the questions, or ran out of questions, you can even place a restart button. So if you press the restart, it goes on a cycle once again. So this is how you need to solve this range error. So that's it for the video. And my Insta program channel, you can also check out my other videos. I've done tutorials in Blender, Unity, C, C++, Java, etc. And make sure you subscribe and support, and thanks for watching.